If you do end up on that top tier fairway, though, you're doing pretty good for yourself. It's just a wedge to the green, and then you're off to the races.
Thanks, John. Conditions are right for scoring, so let's see if they can go low.
I think you'll like that. From 140 yards out. And this for the birdie. And this putt is for par. Just missing. And this one's for the bogey. Ooh, just missing here. And this for the double bogey. And starting the day off at 2 over. And now let's see what this second hole has in store. Well, I'm pretty sure this is going to land in the fairway here. About 160 yards to the pin here. Going with the 9 iron. And that approach is on the green, but quite lengthy putt ahead. Well, I'm sure that wasn't intended. A little bit more work to do now. And about 8 feet to the cup. That'll be for the bogey. And as we look at the board,
starting on a little rough, I'd say.
He's sitting on the top with a score of 3 under.
Oh my goodness.
And next up is a par 4, folks. And I think he will like that. Okay, from 160 yards away. And here's the 6 iron. Pretty sure he's gonna like that one. And 18 feet. Go here. Oh, and the long putt doesn't want to drop. Let's see how things are shaping up on the leaderboard. And currently sitting at 3 over for the day after that hole. And the wind could come into play on this one. I know some others have had some issues. Let's see how this tee shot goes. I think this one's going to find the fairway. And it would appear that shot actually ended up in the rough. This is going to be nice and easy compared to that last shot from 145 yards out. And here's an 8 iron. Might be a bit too much club on this one. And that approach is on with a lengthy putt coming up. That was very close. This one's about 9 feet away. And that putt drops on in for par. And currently sitting at +3 for the day after that hole. Okay, and here is the 5th hole. Taking a shot with the pitching wedge. Could have put a bit too much club on this one. Unlucky on that approach shot. A bit too much club on that one. Oh, goodness. And oh, my, what a putt that was. Very long putt right into the cup. And he is moving up on the leaderboard after that hole. And now the 6th hole. From 250 yards out. And this putt is for birdie. Ooh. And this putt's for par. Oh, my land. That was very close. This one's about 3 feet away. And that hole has led to him falling down on the leaderboard here. And now teeing off on this par four. And nicely done, looking like we'll have some fairway here. And about $1.15 to the pin from here. I think you'll like that. About 13 feet away. And that one will drop for birdie. And our leader today currently on top of things with a round of 4 under par. And now the 8th hole. And now he's going to be digging that putter out. And this putt is for birdie. Ooh, and just inches away. And this is right around the 8-foot mark. Ooh, just missing here. This putt is for the bogey. After that hole, +3 on the day. now setting up for the par four. And I can't see him being too pleased about that. And let's see how this one goes. He's very deep into this rough. He's ended up in the water here, unfortunately, from about 185 yards. I think that's a 5-iron. Okay, and he's on the green now. And 11 feet to go here. Oh my goodness, that was close. This one's about 2 feet from the cup. All right, Luke, we're 9 holes into this final round. What's on your mind? What are you seeing from your vantage point today?
It's a tough day for this player, already outside the top 10 and stumbling. I'd hate to be them at the end of the day.
Thanks for that, Luke. Shot looks a bit off. And this is for birdie. And after that hole, he is moving up on the leaderboard. Okay, now moving on to the 11th. Looks like the hybrid is on display here. Looks like this is going a bit long. I think he'll be happy with that. 34 feet to go here. Just misses. And for the par. Ooh, almost. And about 4 feet from the cup. And that one's right in the cup. And our leader is currently on top. At a score of 4 under par. now we find ourselves on the 12th. Okay, this one's looking pretty good. Nothing wrong with that. And this putt is for birdie. Oh my, this is looking very, very promising. This one's about 2 feet from the cup. And after that one, currently sitting at 5 over for the day. And now, setting up for the next par 4 hole. Well, so far so good for this one. And this next shot, setting up significantly below the hole. That looks like a 5 iron. And nothing wrong with that shot. This putt's for birdie. And for the par. Finishing this hole with a solid putt. And as we look at the leaderboard, score to beat is 4 under. And now setting up for the par 4 tee off. This one's close call. This could be in the rough. And I am pretty sure he's gonna like that. From 18 feet. Ooh, and that was very close. Just didn't drop. And this for the par. And after that hole, he will stay right where he is on the leaderboard. And now setting up on this par 3. Yeah, it looks like a 5 iron. I think he will be pleased with that. Dan, about 30 feet to the cup from here. Oh my gracious, that was close. I'm currently sitting at 5 over for the day after that hole. Next up is the par 5. Well, this one's looking like it's in the fairway. This one's about 8 feet. Ooh, and it just misses. Yeah, they're about 3 feet away here. And our leader today, currently on top of things with a round of 4 under par. Okay, and setting up on the 17th tee. There is some serious power behind this drive, folks. And he's probably gonna like that. And this putt is for birdie. This is looking quite good for the bird. And he will move up on the leaderboard after that hole. And picking up on the 18th hole action here. Let's see what happens. It's looking like this is bound for the short stuff. And this next shot is set up above the hole. Pretty sure that's the 5 wood. Okay, and hitting this par 5 and 2, that's some fine club work out there. this next putt for a final round score of 76. Just missing here. This putt's about 3 feet away. That putt will drop for putt. And as his event comes to an end, not a whole lot to write home about, Luke. I don't feel like he had that competitive edge that you really need to make a dent in the leaderboard.
Well, I don't want to judge, John, but they certainly didn't deliver their best performance today. Well, on behalf of John McCarthy, I'm Luke Elvey. Hope you enjoyed today's coverage. Thanks for joining us for the Skipjack Open.
I'm Luke Elvey. Alongside me for the ride is John McCarthy. Delighted to have your company as we get set for an exciting day's action.
Well, hello, Luke. Fancy meeting you here.
Just getting ready for this next round of golf, John. I'm looking forward to seeing if these guys can take it deep.
Thanks, Luke. We'll talk to you after 9 holes.
And he's got to be happy with that.
And a buck 90 out here. And some unfortunate luck there on that approach shot. Just didn't have enough club. And to save par. This shot is looking too good. And that par putt will drop. And starting today's round off at even par. And teeing off on this par four. This one's a toss up. Let's see where this one will land. And about 235 to the pin from here. Going with the 5-wood here. This is going towards the green here. This for the birdie. Ooh, I thought that was going to go. This putt's looking to be about 2 feet. And he's going to stay right there at even par after that hole. And now let's move to the third hole. And this shot's looking promising. And this next shot is sitting above the hole, so we'll see what happens here. Going with the hybrid here. And not the intended result, I'm sure, on that approach. Just too much club. And about 6 feet away. And that putt drops for par. And he's going to stay right where he is, even par after that hole. And next up is a par four, folks. And look at this drive, just screaming off the club face. Going with the 8-iron. Missing the approach on that one. And that's kind of been the trend for him today. He hasn't been hitting those greens when he has to. This putt is essential to save par. And finishing this one with a good putt. And after that hole, he will remain at even par. Okay, let's see what the fifth has in store for us. And I think he'll like that. And this one could be in the rough, but could not be. Let's find out. And back into the fairway after that shot, and the green is in play. This one's about 3 feet from the cup. And after that hole, he will stay at even par. And now we find ourselves on the sixth hole tee off. Okay, and he's on the green now. And this for the birdie. And a nice putt. And after that hole, one under for the day. And he's also tied for ninth on the leaderboard. Okay, and let's see what the seventh has in store. I think you'll like that. Okay, about 185 yards to the pin. It looks like a 7-iron. And this is looking a bit long, I think. And in the end, I think that's going to play on the green here. Folks, I think this shot's looking too good. And right into the cup. And after that one, currently sitting at 2-under for the day. And he's currently tied for fourth up on the leaderboard. And next on the plate is the eighth hole. Got to be pleased with that. Five feet to go here. And that one goes in for the bird. And he's going to move up in the leaderboard after that one. And the wind could be an issue on this next hole. We're going to have to see how this tee shot goes. Going with the 5-iron here. And the 5-iron is proving to be a bit much for this shot. And not the greatest of swings on that approach shot. And pretty sure the wind was the culprit there. And this is to save par. That's bad luck there. And this one is for the bogey. And the putt will drop. And let's check back in with Luke Elvey. And Luke, what's happening elsewhere on the leaderboard today?
John, the lead is at 4-under, which is pretty impressive, but it's a score that can be beaten.
Let's see what the 10th has in store. Nelson was looking pretty good. And about 13 feet away here. Oh goodness, that was almost in. And this for the par. Currently sitting at 2 under for the day, and he's tied for third place. And moving on to the 11th hole. And fantastic distance on this drive. And about 160 yards to the pin. And this one's for birdie. Well, looks like that putt got away. And from the greenside rough. This putt's about a 2-footer here. Currently sitting at 1 under for the day. And he's also tied for 6th up there on the leaderboard. And now teeing off on this par 4. And a promising looking shot here. And about 175 yards to the pin. I think he's going to like that. This putt's about a two-footer. And it looks like he moved down in the rankings after that hole. All right, let's see what happens on the 13th hole here. And it sounded powerful off the club face. This is going for days. This one looks about 4 feet. And that one will go for birdie. And two under for the day after that one. And he's currently tied for second place on the leaderboard.
Let's give it a go!
Tee off on this par three. Bit of a poor approach shot there. Bit too much club on that. Oh, there was a bit of excitement in there, hey? And this putt could save par. And unfortunately, he's going to move down in the standings after that.
Oh my god. That was wild.
And setting up now on the 15th tee. Find some fairway here. Well, I definitely didn't see that going into the rough, that's for sure. Very nice sand shot. Birdie is very likely. And this putt's for birdie. Nice little putt. And three under for the day after that one. And he's tied for second place on the leaderboard. And setting up for the par 3 hole. Here is the pitching wedge. And this could be long. Ooh, and it just doesn't drop. This one's right around 8 feet. And the par putt drops. And no change in his standings after that hole. And let's see what the 17th has in store. And I think he's gonna like that. And 13 feet to go here. Ooh, unfortunate. And for the par. Folks, this is looking too good. And the par putt will drop. And after that hole, staying fast in the second place on the leaderboard. And as he tees off here on the 18th, with only one stroke between him and the lead, you gotta wonder what's on his mind. He might clear the green with this shot. Yeah, not the greatest luck on that approach shot. Too much club on that one.
You gotta make good of it, Jack.
This next putt for a 69 on the final round. And that will be for bogey. And as his round comes to an end, he's wound up in pretty good shape out there today, Luke.
Top three finishes fantastic in any tournament, anytime. Congratulations to them. An event well played.
Well, that's going to do it from here. I'm Luke Elvey, and from John McCarthy, see you next time.
Well, guys, that's the last golf one. Until next time, ladies and gentlemen, we'll see what we got here. Damn, like evenly matched with that guy. That's wild. Put the back nine in the front and the shot. What would I rate that course? I'm going to give that course. It was fun, so, but it wasn't extravagant. It was kind of hard. Give it a 2. It was because it was gay at the end. Alright. Or, excuse my language, I didn't mean to say gay. It was very weird. It was queer. It was weird. That's what I said. Alright, guys. Well, it looks like, it was wild. Very wild. Back at the clubhouse, grabbing a burger, drinking a brew, closing it out. We'll see ya.